Now, if you know me, you know I'm not exactly what some people call an outdoorsy person. I more prefer the comfort of what I like to call the great indoors. There's the sun, the bugs,
animals, the sunbones, the poison ivy, the poison oak, the ticks.
Today, we are going to dive into one of those reasons, ticks, or more specifically, Lyme disease, which is a very problematic disease for over 30,000 Americans. A great majority of those live right here in the Northeast. To learn more about those pesky ticks and what you could do to ward them off, I'm talking to Dr. Eugene Shapiro, a pediatrician and infectious disease doc who's also an expert on Lyme. All right, enough with this nature stuff. Let's go inside and join me in the exam room.
Lyme disease is a bacterial infection caused by a spirochetal bacteria called Borrelia burgdorferi. It's transmitted by Ixodes ticks. About 90% of people with Lyme disease develop a characteristic rash called erythema migrans. So patients with Lyme disease often have pains in their joints, muscle pains, maybe headache, they may have fever, they may feel tired. The problem is that those symptoms are extremely common in people with a variety of other infections. Those symptoms accompany objective findings, such as the rash, such as a swollen knee joint, such as facial nerve palsy. Because it takes usually 36 to 48 hours or more for an infected tick can transmit. Most people who recognize that they've been bitten and remove the tick are at pretty low risk. Only about 3% of all patients who recognize that they've been bitten will develop Lyme disease. Lyme disease is generally easily treated with a standard course of anywhere from 10 to 28 days of orally administered antibiotics.
So Dr. Shapiro said, if you do want to spend some time outdoors this summer, the best thing to do to ward against ticks is to dress appropriately. So long pants and shorts with sleeves, might I suggest a nice suit ensemble? Using bug spray that protects against ticks, or checking yourself thoroughly when you get home for small poppy seed-shaped bugs that can be found all over the body, but especially in dark, moist areas such as behind your ears or under your arms. Till next month for the Yale School of Medicine, I'm Noah Golden. I'm really sorry for using the word moist.